Mercury sign.
Oh.
What's your sign?
Leo.
Leo, thank you. I'm so kind of Leo.
Lilith in the fourth house. You have to rebel to make a family and have a home. People don't want to even see you have a home and a family, but you make it anyways. That's, do you have kids?
Yeah.
You have kids? Do you have a two sons?
They're grown.
Do you have two sons?
Yeah.
I'm psychic. Okay. Do you have a daughter and two sons?
Yeah. How did you know that?
I'm picking up on it right now. Did you have to leave them with their grandma or your grandma or something? And, okay, the
your
two
grandma.
Of them, they all look different, though. All your kids look different from each other.
Yeah.
One of them's blonde hair, the guy, the son, and he's the tallest. He has blonde hair.
Yeah, he's a rock and roll
okay.
guitarist.
Okay, well, don't tell me. I will tell
you. Oh,
you're just cheating.
You're hitting it right.
That's cheating. No,
I know, but it's
I'll tell you. Let me just get to it, because it happens, and I can't fucking stop it. Okay, and the other son has dark hair like you. Like you. And, your daughter has pale, fair skin, and she has, like, brown hair, and she has a square, she has a square hairline, a square hairline, and her eyes are, like, kind of brown, the daughter, right?
Oh, yes.
But, your son with the blondish, yellowish hair, he has curly hair, and he's taller than the other ones, and he doesn't look like you, but kind of, maybe the lips maybe look like you in a way.
Mm-hmm.
And his eye shape is not like yours. But his eye color kind of is like yours a little bit, but kind of, I can't tell. And, your son, the dark-haired one, like your hair, he has big shoulders. And, he's more like, he has a smushed nose like yours. Your son.
Mine, you know, he's been like this. It happened in a wreck.
Well, yours is kind of like his, right?
Yeah, it never got said when it...
Well, nothing's wrong. Some people have bird noses, you know, some people have pig noses. You know, they're all different shapes. Just saying. So his nose is kind of like yours.
Well, it started out being, and then I got into a wreck, and I didn't...
Well, his nose is like yours, right? The shape. And
yeah.
That's what I'm saying. He has big shoulders.
Mm-hmm.
And
he's a big guy. Yeah,
yeah, and he wears glasses, does he not?
Yeah.
He wears glasses. And
he doesn't wear them. He doesn't like to wear them.
Yeah, I see that too. Okay. Okay. The one with blonde hair, it's short though. It's like short. Until he grew it out. After he was wearing headbands, like
right.
bandanas, he wore like red bandanas.
Yeah.
And he. Okay. Well, I'll tell you. And he started doing comedy or stand up comedy or something. He would be on a microphone at church or something. He would sing for church, do guitars for church, and just preach or something. Was that what he did?
He does that now. I mean, still in
at churches.
At Tulsa, yeah. His church.
In church. Okay. Okay. Does something like that in church. I'm doing good right with that, I guess. And he started growing it out. It's down here. But it used to be short, like military cut, like the other son.
Mm-hmm.
The other son still keeps his hair short, right?
I don't see him that much anymore.
Okay, well, either way, back then. And the daughter, she's quiet, and she has brown hair, a little lighter brown hair than you. And she's fair, beautiful skin, just like the dark-haired son.
Mm-hmm.
They have same skin color. But the redheaded, he doesn't have the same skin color. He kind of has, like, a different type of redneck-ish skin.
He came out different.
Yeah, I mean, they all look beautiful. But they all look different from each other. That's what I'm saying. And, is the dark-haired one a Sagittarius? When is he born?
He was born on August 19th.
Okay, then he's like a Virgo or Leo. I'm not sure if I forgot. And then, I think he's Leo. And then, like fire sign. So is the blonde-haired guy an Aries or Taurus? When are you born?
July 2nd.
Well, I was wrong there, too. He's like a Cancer sign or something. When is the daughter born? She's like a five.
She was August 23rd.
Well, then she is a Leo. I was just trying to see if I can guess their signs, because it's kind of reminding me of whatever. Sounds wrong about the signs. But anyways, and did she work at a library, or she goes to school?
She's in college part-time.
College
and
school.
And she goes to, she's going to school.
Okay, she's going to school. That's what I'm saying. I mean, she's very quiet.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, she's good at school. Or whatever. That's funny. Okay. And then, okay, okay, but did you have to leave? Okay, well, the blonde-haired guy, he's out on his own. He's traveling and stuff, isn't he?
Yeah, well, that's his job.
Okay. So to speak, yeah. Like a big old truck driver, sort of? FedEx kind of person, or?
No, he goes around in something that's encyclopedias type deals.
Well, that's different.
He makes a lot of money doing it, because it pays pretty good, but. He sells encyclopedias, and then they arrive later on.
Okay, well, it doesn't matter. Okay, I'm just trying to see if I can pick up on it. It doesn't matter. Okay, at least I guess I was wrong in a way, but I was right about how they looked and all that stuff. I guess I don't know. Let's see. Okay, did you used to live with your cousin recently? Did he die? He died. Uh-huh. Your cousin. You lived with him. He died, and he was a smoker. And right. Did he was a younger
died of AIDS.
Okay. He had dark hair, right?
It was brown, kind of brown. Blackish. Yeah, like a brown but not quite Indian color, but
like a darkish brown. Mm-hmm. And his eyes was brown, and he was kinda young, right? Mm-hmm. For his age of death. And y'all would sit around in a dark room all the time, smoke and stuff.
I don't know about that. We'd smoke, but not in a dark room.
Okay.
It's funny, though.
Yeah, and, there's people would come over all the time.
Yeah, he liked being around and having his friends around all the time.
Yeah.
He liked to play the guitar for him.
With something with issues with sweepstakes or something?
You could probably see him on the internet. He plays the guitar and also.
Really? That's groovy. Okay. What?
His name is David Allen Griffin Jr.
Okay, well, we'll look that up.
All right, I think. I don't know if
you do. Yeah, it doesn't work on everybody, but I think I'm losing contact, but I'm going to try again.
I'm just so tired. I've been walking around.
That'll make a difference. It helps. You know? Some people who sleep, I can see through their aura, it opens up like black or something, and it shows me everything, but I need a person to confirm everything I'm seeing.
I feel so much better when I get sleeping on it.
Okay, yeah, I know.
I've never been in a situation like this. It's weird, you know, it's weird for me, because I usually try to take care of myself and not invade anybody's space or privacy, you know. And,
right.
And I was in a bad situation because I didn't know what to do, and I wanted help, but I didn't want to bother nobody and come out and say, "Will you help me?" So what I was going to do tonight, if nobody helped me, I just kept walking up and down that until I just collapsed.
No, don't do that.
What I was going to do.
More collapse.
I don't know what.
Well, ask my friend if you could stay there. Your third house, your ninth house is in Pisces, which means you drugs to go to sleep, and you wake up all routine-like, and you wake up perfectionist and OCDC about cleaning. Is that true? Because your third house is in Virgo. That's your house.
Yeah, I mean, I don't like to live in a real dirty house or cluttered.
Well, hell yeah, good for you. Because like your Mercury is also in Virgo. It's analytical and critical and clean and OCDC and organized and all that bullshit. Okay, so yeah, your Venus is in Leo and it's in the second house. You want people to have financial security, and you're probably a money hiring gold digger, and you want all the attention in a relationship, and you're a narcissist, and you like it to be turned into a story and dramatic things. And your Mars is in Libra in the fourth house. You put all your effort into relationships, and your Moon is in Libra, which means you have intoxicating, beautiful vibes, but you are embarrassed so easily for so no fucking reason. You're a hypocrite too, right?
Well, I mean, ever since I got older now, I've changed. When I was a young man, I mean, I was a fairly good-looking young man. But
yeah, that's how your mother treated you, like you were good-looking and an inanimate object.
Yeah, she kept me underneath her thumb. She wouldn't let no one get around me. She spoiled me, and that's what messed me up as an adult, I think.
Okay.
I think, anyway. But
well, That's groovy. And your purpose is to have a home and a family because it's in Cancer. And so that's what you lack. And you'll be having to gain that through the rest of your life.
You know, one thing I could never do.
In the 12th house of spirit. And your spirit's in Gemini. The messenger. The feet. Communication. Wow. Okay, this is your 8th house of death. It's in Aquarius. It means... This is what they say it means. It says an unexpected inheritance, like you inherited somebody's disease or some shit, or like Alzheimer's or some shit and died. Or you get an unexpected inheritance from somebody who dies, like your dad.
My dad did die and leave me here.
Because your Saturn was in Aquarius, so that must mean his death. That's what it shows anyways in here, because of death. Because of Aquarius and his Saturn Aquarius, but your Saturn's in the 7th house of relationships, and you can get relationships, get married, and then it'll be taken away from you if you're a relationship. You have so many opportunities to have relationships because of this placement, but it's taken away from you because you are not a perfect partner for that person. For some ridiculous reason, you have to learn lessons on having a perfect marriage and relationship. Even if you have the opportunity, you think it's all good and it'll take away from you. So have you been doing a divorce like 4 or 5 times or something?
No. I mean, I've just been married twice.
There you go, twice. That's fucking enough opportunities and a waste of money. Bullshit.
Yeah.
So, you know, there's your challenge. And your 10th house is in Aries. 4th house is in Libra. Well, that's the story of, that's the glory of love. Your Pluto's in Virgo. You like to isolate yourself by doing chores and stuff or something. And I don't really know.
I like to stay busy if I can.
Busy.
Or I like to have something to do.
To but, achieve and live to your abundance, sell things, whatever.
She's a sweetie. I think so, don't you?
Groovy. Okay, well, I guess we're gonna go to my. Okay?
She's standing on her back.
Yeah, okay, let's go. Let's go. Bye. What is Knock, who's there? Hey, is that a dog? Are you okay? You having a seizure? It's okay. Sorry to wake you. Didn't know what that is. Looks like a dog. Is that a dog? What is that? I think that's a dog and it's being rocked by its owner. Like, what is that? Is that a dog? Is there more than one person inside that? Is there more than one person? That's probably the dog. What is that? Hey, puppy. Are you okay? It's none of my business, but I'm just wondering, what is that? Okay, time to walk away from the weird. Just stay right over here because you're a stray dog and this is a homeless shelter and this is where you're going. You are saved. It is 5:10 a.m. You have got to go. You're not going to ever go to where I live. No, thank you. Already tricked out. this is where it's at, where you're going to have to stay, and you're straight, and it's really perfect for you in every way. It's only 5:10 a.m. You have 6, 7, 8, 2 hours, 2 hours and 30 minutes till 8 o'clock a.m. Okay, that's your life story. So, you will be awesome.
Is that the right time?
Yeah, it is. See, that's correct time. 5:10 a.m. You're going to be there in 3 hours. This is it. You should chill right here above the moon. And I have to go now. Toodaloo. Mm. Okay? You get to be entertained by whatever the fuck that is, and you'll be able to find out in the morning. No. Whatever the fuck that is. Or whoever the fuck it is. And they'll be nice people, because everyone here is super nice. Okay. Look, there's a person. There's a human being right there. Ask them how much time you have until you have to be here and stuff. There you go. There's your best friend. Thanks, you. See you around. Have a great time. Okay. No, that's an adventure. I found him walking. It was cold. And now I found a place for him to stay. Behold. And he was readable psychically. That's pretty cool. So, that's it. Now I'm coming out of here. Taking somebody's dream or something. It's super fun and nice. This is the best place for a homeless person. Ah, that was cool. I cannot believe I just did that. And it's Halloween now. And I've got to go. Because I want to listen to that. Okay. I'm totally driving down the street. Sing a new one. Okay, like, you're not allowed to know where I live because my boyfriend's gonna be home soon and he's gonna kick both of our asses. Yeah. I don't mean to be hard, don't mean to be rude, but you gotta get away from where I'm staying because my lover is mean and I'm keen, kind, and everything to rewind. What should I have done to these people so I could actually see them? As I read, as I wanna see, right through for you all to see God, cause that's what you do when you find out you have these senses of psychic abilities, and you dedicate your whole fucking life to seeing where I can find God. Through all of you, obviously, it would be the biggest word, because like totally, even that angel said, I'm going to show you a testimony of God, and that you have good chambers, whatever the fuck that means, I got good chambers, whatever the fuck that means, it could be spiritual chambers, like communication chambers or something, or it could be, where is my costume? Turn the radio up and I'm singing this song. Halloween is love and it's costumes all around way. I'm so excited. I'm gonna have to put this on a card and revive a bunch of other people into the astrological atmosphere of the stars talking from within and out. There's a car staring at me with its headlights. I wonder if I'm going to have to turn this off. I guess so. But hey, there was a lightning. Okay, what else did I say? Trying to get back in the psychic realm. Where do I go? I have to exercise my psychic abilities. It is the message for me. I want to be the messenger. Again and again, everyone wants their messages, wouldn't they? Everyone wants. That's what they don't even know, that they wanted to want this. They don't even know. They have got to want this, because that's what I want the most, and everyone to want it to get it again and again. And you don't even have to want it to make me give it to you. The knowledge of what is around you, your atmosphere, and your energy in your whole entire life and existence, and whoever's around you that you've ever existed with, even encountered with, like, hello, I get to look through everything, and it's really fun to tell your story. Is that what we call your story? You are walking around amazing, legendary, ultimately product of your story of your whole entire life and other people's life, their whole entire life that was connected with yours. Okay? Even if they were just part of the past, I can see them really, really fast. You just stay around long enough to get and receive the missions, thy messages. Duh. And so, party like a rock star, party like a rock star. You'll get me to talk your head off about what I see, and that's what you get. And you say yes or no. And then I'm like, wow, whoa. And then it's like, woo, woo. And I can see through the through. And so can you too, and too. And we'll get in the same mind boat. Okay, okay, flowers. I've been up for hours, cause there's work to do. Wake up, flowers. I've been up for hours, cause it's only. And it's like 5:15. No, it's 5:23. Oh, I love and miss thee. I love you, love you now, and I loved you then. I love you, love you, love you.
I don't even sound good. Fuck this. Fuck your love. Get it, get it, get it. Give it away now. What can I do without you? Nothing much but fear. Oh, like, oh, I wanna be a dead deer, a fucking deer for Valentine's Halloween day. I wanna dress up that way, but it's not gonna happen now. My socks are on the ground. I need to fucking get out of my car.
Okay, I want to explain something before I show you what I'm... So you'll know what I'm talking about during the end of this birth chart analysis that I'm doing. Okay, look. Just imagine that this is your birth chart wheel, okay? This is just a color wheel. It's the polarity colors. I just want to tell you this first. Okay, green is the polarity of red. They're opposites of each other. Like, you would think black and white are opposites of each other, because they are, but it kind of didn't fit into the polarities of this diagonally, okay? Okay, purple and yellow are polarity of each other. I love beige and lavender. They're, like, basically polarity. Blue and orange are polarity of each other, in case you didn't know. Wait, blue and orange are polarity of each other. Yeah, okay, this is kind of a different shade. I just want to tell you that, but this, just imagine this is your birth chart wheel, okay? The top, okay, say, you know how there's lines in your chart, you know, and squares and semi-squares and triangles and shit like that. Let me tell you this. Most of the things that are pointing on the above your chart, at the top, that's all going to be seen publicly. That's, you can't hide it. But everything that's at the bottom is private. It wouldn't be seen to everybody. It would be pretty much kept private, like behind the scenes kind of thing. People aren't going to see it. Whether you're trying to publicize it or not, mostly people will see that about you if it's all the top. And if it's the bottom, they kind of just wouldn't know. Okay. So when you're looking at the chart, and you're looking at it this way, this would be, I guess, the left side when you're looking at it. Okay, the left side, if you're looking at it, it's kind of opposite right now, probably. I mean, you're probably seeing the right side of me. I don't know. This is the right side of me. This is the left side of me. But this is, if you're looking at it, facing it, you'll see that this is the left side. The left side of your chart, okay? is the side that you have freedom to create. And whatever is happening here, just it can go anywhere you want it to. Okay? But the right side, if you're looking at the right side with the right hand, which is would be this side, how I'm explaining. This is the side that's your destiny. It's fate. You're destined to happen. No matter what you do, no matter how you get there, whatever you're trying to do, it's supposed to be happening there. And it's kind of like, you know, I don't know, free will, it's going to just be like that. If it's a shitty thing, it's going to be there. If it's a good thing to hold you back or to keep you up, it's destined to happen on this side. Whether it's going to be easy for you or hard for you, it's just going to, it's supposed to happen in its own way. But this side, I mean, you have the freedom to make on the left side. You're facing it, the left side of your hand. Then it's the side that you have the freedom to create it in whatever you want it to be. If that makes any sense. Whatever planets on each side, north, south, east, west. I think that's north, south, east, west. Yeah, north, south, east, west. Is that correct? Yeah. So I guess the water witch side is where the destined stuff is supposed to be. Whatever. So I got a lot of things pointing to that side. The destiny side, the fate side. Like it's meant to happen. Meant to happen. I don't got really much coming from this side. But you know, polarities, you know, up and down, around and around. I have a lot of things on the top. So everything is being seen. I'm putting it publicly out there. Kind of, you know. So that's an interesting thing to think about during, if you want to see. Okay. Toodles, whatever. You know, just a little fasting. I wanted to let y'all know. That's in a bar chart. You're a Cancer. And in the seventh house of your shadow self. So you're actually Capricorn rising, so you come off as very serious. You have a Capricorn beautiful goat face. And all kinds of Cancer signs are attracted to you, I guess. You attract a bunch of Cancers and you might see them as different from you. You might not like them. And so you might not like yourself. And you might think yourself as different from yourself. You're more like a Capricorn because you are Capricorn rising. That's what I thought. So you're really serious about your reputation and your career and being Cars. And then your moon is in Gemini, so your mom's like a two-faced bitch. And your moon is in the sixth house, so she's critical of you. And plus, you like day-to-day routines, and that's how you deal with your emotions. And every day you are a communicator at your job, working or whatever, you always have to use your hands or something. And also, you might be schizophrenic, you have voices, racing thoughts in your head, and you might you'd be really funny, and then all of a sudden you'll snap into a personality that's just not funny anymore. You just become this controlling brat, like if somebody doesn't feel the same way or think the same way you do. Because moon is your inner being, your mind, and your emotions. This is how you deal with your emotions. And Gemini is a mental sign, but when it becomes an emotional, it becomes very irrational. But when it's mental, it's more logical and cold. Unemotional, but so that would be your inner self, and you are analytical with your emotions. So since it's the sixth house ruled by Virgo, so you'll write a list, be like, Wednesday I think I'm just gonna have my breakdown then, or you have, it's slower to digest your emotions to figure out how you feel or something, and then you make yourself go through a routine or whatever, and if you're outside that routine, or a person's outside your routine, then you'll flip out and be psycho. Is that kind of true?
I'll accept the flipping out part.
So it's a routine. You like to have a stable routine so you can feel better, and you like to work, and you don't like to not work.
If they change my days off at work, I get blacked
out. Alright, you're right. See? Something like that.
I threaten to quit at least once a week.
Oh. That minimum. So that's flipping out. Your third house is in Pisces, so
You're really sweet, nice when you communicate, and people will believe you. But also, your Mercury is in Leo, and it's in the 7th house. So you see Leo as different from you. You're like, oh my God, they're such a narcissist, and like, because they are, getting all this unearned attention. But when you speak, you get a lot of attention, unearned attention too, and you're secretly kind of like a narcissist in a way, because you actually are a narcissist, and you have to let go of your narcissist because your Saturn is in Leo, and your Saturn's in the 8th house. This is your life lessons, karma, discipline, and your 8th house is actually your death house. It means in your sex, death, and transformation house. That's how you transform yourself into, when you're in despair, you act like a Leo, maybe. And so since your Saturn, your dad was probably a narcissist. He was probably your biggest fan. And he saw your talent or something. Was he? Was he like a narcissist?
My dad got killed when I was 2 years old. I don't even know him.
Okay, so do you think you kind of are a narcissist? And it's kind of crumbling your ego to where you're like not a narcissist, and also you rather work than have fun. You kind of feel weird about having fun and also having sex, and you have lessons to learn about sex, death, and transformation, and it could crumble your ego, it could heighten your ego, and you it's like you have opportunities to become like this actor or model or something, and you can draw like super good, but you think it's just mediocre because your ego is so crumbled that you think it's like no good, and you don't want to be in the spotlight because you might have to learn another lesson or something.
You tell me that,
Robert. Really? What is that? A drawing?
Yeah.
That looks
freaking super good.
Look at that bedroom.
Oh my God! You drew that, and this is like a hand and a face and like a lips, and then the eye and the nose and the lips is like two faces or something. Wow. So see, like I said, this can give you the opportunity to draw super good pictures and stuff, but you see them as mediocre, but like you should be in the spotlight for this. Like you could be an actor, a model, and a genius expression, a person who expresses themselves. This is the Saturn and Leo kind of thing. Expressing yourself, being creative. Being super creative. Oh my gosh, even more cool. Like a Aquarius rising, because you have like Leo, 8th house in
this one.
Oh my gosh, that is so amazing. Star Trek, the whole thing, that looks very, very real.
Over there.
Oh my God, and this too?
No, not that one.
Okay, well that's a cool picture anyways. Wow, very cool.
And these three up here.
Very cool. Very cool. And then these three. Oh my gosh, that's so beautiful. And it looks like Tyra Banks. Is that Tyra Banks? Is this supposed to be Tyra Banks?
Yes.
Oh my God, it looks exactly like her, and she's a Sagittarius. She has coke hands for her hair. Oh, it's an Indian, a beautiful Indian.
Look at the face closely.
Oh, who's that? That's the girl. She's a Scorpio, and she's Katy Perry or something.
And
this one is, I don't know, but I can tell that it's somebody that you have idolized or something. I can tell it's somebody else. It's somebody who's dressed like Indian and doesn't always dress like Indian. Who is that?
Cher.
That does not look like Cher. But it looks like somebody else. Is this what you drew too?
No, I didn't draw
that. Okay, you didn't draw that, but whatever. Okay, anyways, so this is something. Oh, wow. 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 Who's that? That's the star, isn't it?
Del Rey or whatever.
Oh my gosh, you are such a genius. See, this is, oh my God, that's from Aladdin. That's Bush. That's Robin Williams. Wow, he's an Aquarius. Oh, he is. That is all Robin Williams in the genie. Anyways, wow, that's so cool. See, I told you you would have this amazing ability to express yourself, and probably you're good at music, maybe.
No, not really.
Okay, well, you would be good at drawing. It's really good. And you probably would drink on the weekends or something to have fun. Not, like, all the time. Not, like having have an addiction or whatever. You just have it, like, a monitored, you know, kind of thing.
I haven't had alcohol.
Well, that's good. And so, But you are the work than play kind of weird, feel weird about having fun. Because that's what Leo is. It kind of restricts you from that kind of thing. It wants to make you humble and all that stuff. Have a good ego, a humble ego, instead of like this narcissist ego. You know what I mean? Yeah. And that's what it's trying to teach you. Because like it could give you this opportunity to be this amazing actor and stuff, or drawler, you know? And you can have this. It'll take away from you if you're like this asshole narcissist about it. You notice how that might be happening in your life? Like, people tell you, bring you up to where you think is like, oh, that's too much of a high pedestal, but because I'll just fall off of it anyways, and I might as well stay at where I'm at. Is that how that is?
A little bit.
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking. So, and then your Venus is in the fifth house. That is also ruled by Leo, and your fifth house is in Taurus. You want somebody whose financial secure, your Venus is in Gemini. You're kind of like a player. You want a sample of everybody. You treat everyone like they're the person you're going to be with, but you're kind of a player. You're playing them, and then you're with somebody that, like, you're the only person I'll be with, and you'll move, and you'll be like, and then you get rid of everybody, and you're like, okay, we're just going to be a couple, or whatever. And is that how that is? Your Mars is in Taurus, which means you don't like to get mad. You don't want to ruffle feathers. You don't want to eliminate the pleasures in life. Like, someone could buy your Girl Scouts cookies, or this person, I'm not going to be mad unless they keep on nitpicking me. Then, finally, you explode, and you become really mad, and they wish they did not get
it. It takes a lot to make me mad.
Yeah, it takes you a lot to. That's what Mars and Tauruses always say. It takes a while for them to be mad. You just nitpicking. Then you're mad.
When I was younger, it was different.
And it's also in the fifth house, so when you get mad, you can do petty things against people. You like, you know what I mean? Okay, your Jupiter's in Gemini, which means you are lucky with being a public speaker, communicating, a good writer. Do you write stories and stuff, or just write a writer, publisher?
No.
Your Jupiter, that's just your planet of luck and higher learning expansion. And it's in the sixth house of day-to-day routines, and your health, your diet. So it could be lucky with that. Your eighth house is in Leo. Like I said, you could die of a heart attack or something.
Probably.
But after you die, you'll be famous and well known after you're dead. You know what I mean? Isn't that crazy?
Heart attack sounds about right.
Really, it does? Mm-hmm. So I was right about your heart attack. Is that just like a joke?
No, I'm just, you know, the doctor tells me it's coming one day.
Oh, no, your doctor says it's about your heart.
Yeah, because my mom had one.
Oh, your mom had one.
My grandpa died of heart attack.
Oh, my God.
It's in the family.
Okay.
Just like diabetes.
Isn't that crazy how astrology is telling you this? This is my interpretation, though. I'm just analyzing this. Look, this is all I'm reading right here. This is all I'm reading. This is your placements. This is your forecast in outer space.
Well, I don't know a lot about that stuff, so.
Because of people. I have to learn through other people. Anyways, your Uranus is in the midheaven, and your midheaven's in Libra, so when everyone sees you, like, in a picture with somebody else, or, like, on Facebook or something, they'll be like, oh my god, you're gonna get married? Like, everyone thinks that you're, like, such marriage material in the public's eye, and, like, then it's, like, a month later, you're like, take a picture with somebody else, and it's like, are you going to get married? Is that like you're a serial monogamous marriage
okay, put it this way. In the last 5 years, I've taken one person, one picture with people.
Yeah.
And that was yesterday.
Okay.
We went to a haunted house, a bunch of us from work, and they wanted a picture.
Oh, wow. Haunted houses are already coming around.
Yeah, they started in first week of September.
Oh my gosh, I want to go so bad. Okay, tell me about that later. Your Lilith is in Gemini, which means people don't want to see you become a liar, and it's in the fifth house. People don't want to see you a petty narcissist. People don't want to see you how you spend your money weirdly in Taurus and artificially, and steal money or whatever, which people don't want to see you a liar. You're probably a liar then.
Nope.
A storyteller. Okay, well, good. Because Lilith in Gemini usually makes people a liar. Your Pluto's in Libra, which means when you isolate yourself, you don't like to be alone. You isolate yourself with somebody else to be alone with yourself. Does that make sense?
I'm trying to.
And it's in the ninth house of higher learning expansion. You isolate yourself from learning something, going on an adventure, day-to-day routine. Who knows? I don't know. Your philosophy is to be analytical and perfectionist or whatever, but you go to sleep, like, analyzing everything, and want everything in order and clean something before you go to bed. And then when you wake up, you're all like happy hippie, or miserable hippie or Pisces hippie or chameleon hippie when you wake up or something, because your third house is in Pisces. Your ninth house when you go to bed, it's like in Virgo, like, I need to clean something before I go to bed. OCD when you go to bed, you know? Is that how that kind of is?
Kind of.
I need to choose something, live to my abundance before I go to bed, kind of thing, your philosophy. And also, like I said, like you said with animals, it would be very healthy for your philosophy to be with animals, but you're contradicting to where you're like, you don't want the responsibility with animals because you'd rather have your work, your job, and you don't have to worry about potty training an animal. Is that right? Kind of like that? So that's
the whole reason I don't want animals.
It's the whole reason.
They make your house smell weird.
Yeah. So it's like you're nitpicky about the philosophy. And your 11th house is in Scorpio with all your friends. So you might like deplete all your friends because like, of a misunderstanding and not forgive them or something. Who knows?
I'm too forgiving.
Oh, really? Well, that's good. Because that's your third house is in Pisces of forgiving. The crowd might be there. Your 12th house is in Sagittarius, a lucky spirit, blah, blah, blah. Your north knot is in Libra. You're meant to be married. You're meant to be in a relationship. You're meant to see the shadow self of other people, blah, blah, blah. You're meant to have the 8th, 9th house, have a philosophy, blah, 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 blah. Okay. Let's get to the point. Crown and Taurus is how you heal yourself. Like, with artificial spending money and value and beauty and who the fuck knows, financial security. Your Ceres is in Libra. This is how people come to you. This is what people come to you for. This is how you heal others. By being beautiful and balanced and relational and marriage material, people think, oh, I just want to pretend I'm married to you because that's how I heal myself, because of your bondingness or some shit and your beauty and your balance. Does that make sense? Or relationship advice or something? That makes sense. How
a
people
lot
come.
Of people ask me shit about that. I'm like, how do I know?
A lot of people come to you thinking that this is what they're going to be healed from you.
People at work do all the time. They want to talk to me about fucking relationship problems.
And that's how they heal. That's how you heal them, whether you know it or not. See, like you said, you don't know it. Well, how am I supposed to know? But, and that's your healing for other people. That's why they come to you for that. Isn't that cool?
I don't know why they do. I mean, I can't make a relationship last, so how can I help you make yours last?
I think that's cool. It says it. Your Ceres is in Libra. It means that's how you heal other people. That's what they come to you for. So you just make something up for them. Just give them a little healing.
Okay. I just tell them stuff I see on TV all the time.
Right. Well, morals are on TV and it should be known. That's how it should be taught. Your palace is in Virgo. Your creative, like you said, when you see it, an object, you see all the parts and stuff. You analyze them. Like I said, it was like a Virgo thing. And it is Virgo. Palace is a Virgo. When you do your creative hobbies is you to analyze things and put them to pieces and get rid of the impurities and take what's minerals and, you know, the good things about it and put it together and make it perfect, you know. So that's what it is. That's your creative abilities and your palace in Virgo. Like how you want to decorate your house. It's kind of like all neat and organized and stuff. So, that's what you got there. My palace is in Pisces. It's polarity of your Virgo. I don't know what house that yours is in, but mine's in the just public image. I don't know. But that's cool. So, your Juno's in Scorpio. So, like, you might go to a funeral or something and you meet somebody that you might want to marry or something.
I've only been like one funeral in my last two.
Okay. Did you meet anybody you went out with? Okay. Your Vista is in Leo, or the cult, someone who knows occult knowledge and stuff. Your Vista is in Leo, so you've been given the gift with all this unearned attention and this very great expression, your writing skills, and all that good stuff, right? Told you. Your Saturn in Leo gives you opportunities for this stuff, and it can take it away from you, and just wants to humble you, blah, blah, blah. Your fortune is in Scorpio, your South Node is Aries, okay. Most of your life is public and seen, and half of your life is fate, like it's going to happen no matter what, and half your the other half of your life is you got freedom to create, like your midheaven, your public image, you have freedom to create that, but it's in the public's eye somehow, and there's nothing public, I mean, there's nothing private about your life that people don't see. Is that kind of true? Pretty much everyone sees everything about your life, and you're destined to be Cancer. You're destined to everyone sees your luck too, like your Jupiter, Leo, everyone sees in your mom. Your mom's kind of private, but kind of still totally destined to be or something. Your mom's still alive or whatever?
Yeah.
Okay. It's did whatever destined that is supposed to be for. And that's the story of, that's the glory of love and light. So was my analytical thing okay?
For the most part, there were a few parts that weren't accurate, but
okay.
For the most part.
That's groovy. Okay, you are a Leo, Moon in Libra, Cancer rising, 10th house Aries. Your 8th house is in Aquarius. That's your death house. Let's see. Your sun is in the 2nd house Leo. That's like a ton of Taurus-y vibes. I don't know. Your moon's in Libra. This is how your mother treated you. And it was in the 6th house day-to-day routine. She was probably critical of you. She was fake and hypocritical. It makes you bashful and shy and embarrassed very easily. But you'd be arm candy to other people and always in a relationship. And she just treats you like an inanimate object. And she traveled around because your 6th house is in Sagittarius. So you are used to always traveling around, right?
Yeah, my dad was in the airport.
So you really don't have a home. Your 4th house is in Libra. She still treats you like an inanimate object. Your dad was either your friend or he was an egotistical maniac and he was racist, prejudiced, and or oh, he was like your friend.
No, he was.
Did he die?
He was mean and he hated blacks and he was like a redneck type.
So he was like a hypocrite. He was like a racist, prejudiced person who did not want you to be yourself, right?
Right, exactly.
And you had to rebel to find yourself.
And he got drunk and he was mean, you know. But when he got older, it seemed to straighten out, and we got to be best friends.
There you go. That works. That's the challenging lessons you have to learn through that. And it says he might be dead, you know. And it also says the 6th, 7th house. Oh, you keep on attracting everyone like your father, everyone that's different from you, you think is different from you, but you attract people that are just like your father. And that's you're secretly kind of like your father. Because it's your shadow self, is your 7th house in the Capricorns. Your Lilith is in Scorpio. That is how you rebel and people don't want to see you do these things and things that happen to you with that. Let's see, Scorpio. Lilith.